Hello everyone, do you hear me correctly? Okay. So my name is Maxim, and today I'm going to speak to you about Scout, Algolia, and Vue.js, and how you can build a really great search with it. So a bit about me. I live in Paris, in France, and I work at Algolia in their Paris office. I'm a search lover. It's been a bit more than 2 years that I work at Algolia, and during this time, I started to appreciate everything there is about search. The algorithms, the ecosystem around it, the UI and the UX that you can provide with it, and it's been great so far. And I'm a Laravel user. I've used it for the past 5 to 6 years, maybe, both in personal project and in professional project. And I've been, I'm proud to have been able to contribute by building the search and the documentation that you have on the Laravel doc. Funny thing is that Laravel was actually the first doc that we integrated in, and then it ended up being a product that we call DocSearch that we provide, as Tyler said, for free for any documentation. So let me explain you a bit the tools that we are going to work on today. So the first one is Laravel Scout. So what this is? It's a package that you install on your Laravel app. And what it allows you to do is to basically search on top of your models. So what you say is, I want this model to be searchable. And Scout is going to take care of all the indexing, the synchronization from your database to the search engine. And on top of that, it's going to allow you to search on top of this data that is in the search engine. It is driver-based, meaning that you can plug to any search engine. Algolia is the default driver for Scout, and we are very proud of that. A bit more about Algolia. Algolia is an API. It's a nested search API. So everything that you do with your search, you interact through it with the API. If you want to search, to index your data, to configure the relevance, everything goes through the API. And what this API allows you to build is really relevant search. You have inside Algolia all the tools out of the box to do really great relevance. And it's really fast. You might have seen it on the doc. As soon as you type something, you get the result instantly wherever you are. And the reason it is that fast is because it's been built from the ground up to do such as you type experience. And on top of this API, we provide a lot of building blocks that you can use to easily display and build search UIs. One of the UI that you can build with it is those type of instant search result page. So it looks like a classic search. You have the input, the result, some filtering on the left. That's basically the stuff that you find in any e-commerce search, but also on other type of websites. The main difference is that everything that you type, everything that you refine, so if you refine your query, it's going to refresh the whole UI, every keystroke, every filter. And it's instant, as you can see on the image. To build such experience, there is 3 steps. The first one is to import your data. So you have all this data in the database, and you want to take it and put it in the search engine. Once you put it, you also want to synchronize it. So every time you do an update on your model, in the case of our Laravel app, you also want it to be refreshed in the search engine, because when you search, you want the data to be up to date. Once you do that, the second step is to configure the relevance. So Algolia provides a very good out-of-the-box relevance, but you can give it some metrics to better rank the results depending on your business metrics. For an e-commerce website, for example, you might want to do the number of sales of a product and rank depending on that. And those metrics, you can choose it depending on your business need. And the third step is you have all this data in the search engine and you want to display it. So how does that translate into the Algolia ecosystem? So I mentioned you have the API. You have your backend that is going to import and synchronize your data. In this case, we're going to use Scout, and Scout is going to do this job for us. Scout also enables you to search on top of your data. But that it has one downside is that your backend becomes a bit a middleman. Why? Because the end user does a query, it goes through the backend, the backend calls Algolia, Algolia responds to the backend, and the backend responds to the user. And doing that, you lose the speed of Algolia. So what we usually recommend instead is to do the search part from the front end. So the browser of the end user is going to query directly Algolia, the search engine, and this allows to have very instant results. When you do that, you get the raw data from the engine, but it can be quite hard to display it properly. You need to do a lot of stuff. So you need to display, you need to keep the search state, so the current filters, the current search, the pagination, all of that, you need to deal with it. And that can take quite a while. That's why we built a few libraries that you can use called Instant Search. And those libraries, what they allow you to do is to do these front-end experiences, those UI, very quickly. Today we have two, Instant Search for JavaScript, which is a vanilla JavaScript library, and a second one that integrates better into React apps. And today we are releasing a third one, which is Vue.js Instant Search. So why is this interesting for the Laravel community? At Algolia, our goal is to make this experience of building search as fast as possible. And since last year, I think, Laravel ships with Vue.js by default, and this library, I'm going to show it to you, and you will see that you cannot do a lot faster than this. So let's build the search together. Before I'm going to dive in, I'm going to give you a bit of context of what I want to show you. So you are here because you are using Laravel in some way, probably, or you will use it at some point. All these apps that you are building, they probably either need search or will need search at some point. And my goal is to show, on top of an existing app, how can you build a search for your data. So I built a very small app that just list the Laracon speakers. So I took the speakers from this Laracon and the one in Europe, in Amsterdam, next month. So I just list them. I have the name, the title, the image, the conferences they are attending to, so either EU, US, or both. I can edit the speaker. I can add a speaker. So quite simple app, nothing fancy. Let me show you how that translates into the Laravel app. So I have my root file, where I have all the logic. I did not took the time to put that into controller. The app is very simple, and for the sake of simplicity, I kept that here. So I display my views, I add, update the data in the database, and I have a route to delete. Very simple, I'm not going to dive too much into it, since we are not going to touch that. More interesting, we have the speaker model. So the speaker model, I have many-to-many relationship with conferences. So a speaker can attend many conferences, and a conference can host many speakers. And I have a helper method helping me to know if a speaker attends a conference. I have also one helper method in a trait that is giving me the pass to the image to be able to display it. I have a conference model, default model, nothing fancy on this one. And last, I have my view. Very simple as well. I just loop over all the speakers, display the image, the name, the title, the conferences, and my two buttons to edit and delete. So our goal is going to be to transform this view into an instant search view. So as I mentioned before, doing search experience is three steps: import, configure the relevance, and build the UI on top of them. So we're going to go over the three steps. The first one, importing the data. I mentioned we're going to use Scout, And let me clear that. And first thing we need to do is to install Laravel Scout, and we do it via Composer. I'm not actually going to run it because I don't trust the network at all, even if I'm going to use the network. And once I do that, I need to enable it. So PHP artisan vendor publish, and I publish the config file. Once I do that, I have this scout configuration file, and inside I can configure the behavior. So I have the default driver, which is Algolia, and I'm going to keep it since I want to use Algolia. You can configure the prefix of the indices. So every indices you can configure to put a prefix, and I'm going to keep it empty, but this can be useful in case you have several environments and you want to have a dedicated set of indices for each one of them. You can decide to do the indexing job inside the queue or not, and you have the credential that you need to fill. So when you are using a SaaS software, you usually need credentials. And in our case, to get those credentials, we can get them in the Algolia dashboard. So I'm going to put them in my end file. And get that from the Algolia dashboard. So I already created an account. You can create one for free. And inside this dashboard, I can manage everything related to Algolia, including grabbing my keys. So I'm going to copy the ID, the admin IP key. The reason why I'm not taking the search key is I also want to write into the indices, so I need the keys that have the rights to do that. So we are good, and last step is to enable it. So in config app, I'm just going to add the Scout service provider. Once I do that, if I run PHP artisan, I have two more commands, flush and import from Scout, that are going to allow me to import the data. So I'm going to use the import command. Scout import, and I specify the model. I also need to specify inside my model that this model needs to be searchable. I mentioned at the beginning, Scout, his job is to say, I want this model to be searchable, and then it's going to allow you to do that. So I'm going back to my speaker model, and I just say this model is searchable. So I use the searchable trait of Scout. And I run it. That's done. And I want to check that this was imported properly. So I'm going back to my dashboard. And in indices, I see that my speakers are already there. So as you can see, it's quite instant. I have all the information that are on my models. So the name, the title, created that, updated that, the image. And you have this object ID, which is a unique identifier that you need to provide. And by default, Scout is doing that for you, and it's taking the ID of the model. This can be configured, but by default, it's taking just the ID, so we see that ID and object ID is the same value. What's good with the Algolia dashboard is that you can directly try out the search and see if it works properly. So if I look for Taylor, for example, I found him, that's good. If I look for myself, I'm finding myself, that's great. One issue that we have is that if I tap JPG, I found some stuff, and I should not. No speakers in name is named JPG. And the reason for that is that by default, we are looking into all the attributes. And that's actually a bad practice. When you do search, you want to avoid as much as possible the noise that you can create. And one way to do that is to target only the attributes that you really want to be searchable. In our case, just the name and the title. So I'm going to go ahead and just configure that. So I want the name to be searchable and the title. I'm going to save. And when I refresh, right now if I tap JPG, I don't have any noise anymore. So it's already better. In my record, right now I don't have the conferences the speaker is attending to. So if I want to display that, I won't be able to because it's not there on the record. So Scout allows to configure what is sent to Algolia. So I'm going to override the toSearchableArray method. And what it does by default internally is this. It just takes the model, converts it to an array, and returns the array. The reason why conferences are not indexed by default, it's not directly on the table. It's on the relationship, so in another table. So we need to specify that we want this model. So I'm just going to do array conferences equals this conferences. And the same that for the speakers, when I do that, it's going to dump the whole record. And I don't want that. In the end, in the conferences, I just want the location. So I'm going to map over the conferences. And return the location. We had a few information that we don't need, like the created at and the updated at. So I'm going to just transform this into a more simple thing. In the end, I need name. Title. And image. I'm going to run again the Sorry?
In your map?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So I import again, and if I go back to my dashboard right now, we should have the record like we want. So record is clean. I have only what I need, nothing more, nothing less. So we finished this first step. The first step was importing and synchronizing. We just import the data. Actually, the synchronization is already done as well. We didn't have to do anything. Scout is going to take care of that. As soon as we modify a model, it's going to update it. If we delete something, it's going to delete it as well from the engine. So we are good. First step, done. Second step, relevance. Right now, the ranking of the search is quite random, I would say. If I tap T, I have Tom that is first, but for no specific reasons. What I want is to give some metrics to Algolia that it can use to rank the result better. In my database, I don't have those metrics, and in the records right now, I don't have them as well. So I'm going to create some. One of the metrics that I can use is the speakers that are attending two conferences. I want to rank them first because they are doing two. They are most probably a bit more popular than the ones that are doing only one. And when I type T, most probably, I also want Taylor first because he's the laurel creator. So I'm going to add two metrics. So those two metrics in my record, I'm adding the number of conf. Count and is Laravel creator. Very simple condition. Name equals Taylor Otwell. So right now I define two metrics and I'm going to re-import my data so I have it on Algolia. When I refresh, I have those two metrics. So number of conf and is Laravel creator. So right now, we are good. What we want to do is tell Algolia to use those two attributes as custom ranking. So we go in the ranking tab, and we add two custom ranking. One is number of conf, and the second one is Laravel creator. I save, and then when I go back, it's already ordered better. I have Taylor first, he's the creator of Laravel, and he's speaking at both conferences. Then I have people speaking at two conferences, then one. If I tap T, right now our results are better. I have Taylor first and then the other speakers. So With a very few configuration and metrics that I added, my search is already a lot more relevant. When I tap T, I'm going to find Taylor. That's a lot better. So we finished the two first steps. Importing the data, configuring the relevance. Let's go ahead and start the third step, which is building on top of this data the search UI. So what we want to do is to replace this page with a page that is searchable and that refreshes instantly. So for that, we're going to use the new library, View Instance Search. And for that, we need to install it. Same as for Scout. I'm not gonna run it, but I'm gonna show you how it looks. So I do npm install view instance search. It's gonna install the package, and I can start using it. It's already installed, so we don't have to do that. I'm gonna run npm run watch, so it compiles all my JavaScript into one bundle file, and then we don't have to deal with it anymore. So every time I save, it's gonna update the JavaScript. I put that on the side. And same as for Scout, I need to enable it. So I'm going to the app file, not this one. Yes. So this app file, it's out of the box with Laravel. So when I was saying, you don't have to do anything, you don't have to do a lot to set up, it's because these view files, they are already ready, and you have only two lines to do to use view instance search. You require it. Search require view instance search, and I tell view to use it, and that's it. So very simple way to install it. So what is view instance search? It's a set of components that you can use to display the search results. You have a lot of components. We're going to use a few of them, but you will be able to go on the documentation and see there is a lot more that we provide. I'm going back to the app. We see that in this file, the app is going to run inside an app ID, and right now we don't have it, so we just need to add it to our view. So here I'm just adding an app ID, and I can start using my components. So the first thing I need to tell view instance search is which index I want to search on top of. So I'm going to use the index component, and it takes a few props. The app ID, the API key, the index name, and I could fetch that from Scout, but for this example and the sake of simplicity, I'm just going to fetch it from the dashboard. So I take the app ID. This time, I don't need the write key. I just need the search key. So I'm going to take this one. And I need an index name that is speakers. And this is generated from the model name. So I told Vue.js which index I'm going to use. And now I can start using my components. So I'm going to use three for now. The first one is an input. And on the input, I'm going to put a placeholder. Search for speakers. And this is a very good practice. When you have a search input, it's a really good practice to put a placeholder. And the reason is you want to tell your end users what they are going to be able to search on top of. I'm going to use the results component so I can display the result. And we are going to paginate the result, because when you do a search experience, you don't need to have a very long list of results. In the end, you are able to refine the query with search, with filters. So having a small amount is enough. So results per page. I'm going to put 6. And I need to display this pagination. If I go back to my app, I see that I have my input, the results, the pagination. Right now, the results are not really fancy. It's the default template. It just displays the object ID. The pagination is already working. We see that the results are updated. When I type something, it's also refreshing. So all this binding with Algolia, you didn't have to care about it at all. It just works. You just say, I want to do that, and it does it for you. What we want now is to take this display and put it in here. So I'm just going to copy paste, not like this. This, I'm removing the loop. And inside the result, I can configure the template of what it. So template, this template, inside this template, we have access to one variable, which is result. And this result is one it coming from Algolia. So it's going to have the format that is on our index. So we'll be able to call result.name, result.title, and so on. Inside this template, I'm just going to copy that. And what I want right now is to remove all the blade templating and put a view templating instead. So I'm going to replace that. It's not speakers anymore, it's results. The arrow syntax is not valid in JavaScript, so I replace it with a dot. All the attributes, the HTML attributes that I want to bind dynamically, I need to add a vbind directive. So vbind, and same for the href that are there. Vbind. Up. Vbind. In the vbind, it's JavaScript, so I don't need the curly brackets. This is good, this is good. I still have a blade loop, so I'm going to remove it and replace it with a view loop. V4. And location in results.conferences. Conferences. Inside result.conferences, what we have, we see that we have the location directly. So the value is going to be directly in location. So in the end, we just need location. And as I mentioned, inside the vbind, it's JavaScript. So I can just modify those two to be JavaScript inside. So I'm going to concatenate. This. And that's it. I think I'm good, so I'm going to refresh the page. And I have one issue. We still use the curly bracket, and by default, Blade tries to interpret them. That's not what we want. In the end, the template that we have now, it's a view templating. So we're going to add a verbatim directive from Laravel to say, please, Blade, don't touch this part. And when I refresh, I have my search, and the placeholder is not working. I forgot the yes. So I can search for speakers, Taylor, if I look for myself, working well, the pagination working as well. So the amount of work required to do that, it's actually really small, and this is a great improvement compared to before. But we can do better. For example, when I tap Evan, right now I have three results, but I don't really know why they are matching. And Algolia provides a handy feature, which is called highlighting. So I'm using the Vue Chrome extension to look at what is inside my components. And in there, I see that I have the attributes that are in my record, and I also have this highlight result that also contains the searchable attributes inside. And it explained me what it matched by wrapping with an HTML element. So I'm going to use this instead. So just for the name and title, dot, and it's inside the value. When I refresh, and I type Evan again, I have the highlighting. It's not yet perfect because Vue is escaping the content by default. So we want to tell Vue not to escape this. So for that, I'm just going to modify a bit, taking the content and putting it in a VHTML directive. And when I refresh, right now, if I tap Evan, I know what it matches. So it's already a lot better. We see that it matched because I am one typo away from van, which is the explanation of why we have three results and not just only one. So this is better, but we can also do again better. when you are doing a search, you want to be able to filter down to what you want. Maybe I'm not interested in the US speaker, I just want to search into EU speakers, and also people that are only doing one talk, so if they're doing both EU and US, I don't really care, I'm interested in the others. Right now I cannot, I need to go through all of them, go through all the pagination, it's not practical. So we're going to add those refinements. Those refinements, we're going to put it on the left, like the demo I showed you before, so I'm going to just modify a bit the DOM to let space for that. So just a container, a left div and a right one. Inside the right one, I'm just going to copy paste result and pagination components. And in the left one, I'm going to use another component that view instance of provide, the refinement list. And list, and I need to tell which attribute I want to filter on. So attribute name. And I want to filter on top of conferences. And I also want to filter on the number of the attribute that I computed before. So that's all I need. I also need to tell Algolia that I want to refine on those one, because for every query, it's going to compute the values, the possible values. So in display, I'm configuring my two attributes, so conferences and number of conf. And when I refresh, it should, it is almost. I'm missing something. Yes, I put an S. Yep. So I have my filters there. I don't have any context of what this is, so I want to configure the way it's displayed. And one of the ways to do that is to configure only the header. So I'm going to override the default template for the header of this section. So the header, and I'm just going to put a bold title, which is conferences. And I'm going to do the same for number of conferences. And when I refresh, that's already better. So right now, the thing that I wanted to do, so being able to search only in EU speakers and speakers that are only doing one conference, I do EU, one speaker, and I can search on top of them. So it's already better. One of the issues that we have is that when we tap a random query, we don't really know if it's working or not. We have no information. So this is a bad practice. To avoid that, we usually display a small message saying no result for this query or something like that. And this can be done very easily. I say I want a no result message. And when I refresh, I have my message. So as you see, very simple. It's been 15 minutes, and I index my data, configure the relevance, display the search UI, and I have actually a pretty kick-ass search for the time I spend on it. So that's what we are releasing today. I hope you like it. Let me go back to my slides. A few links that can be interesting for you. First of them are the Scout documentation. So you have the one that is on the Laravel. On the Laravel documentation. This one is very Scout focused, and we have one that is a bit more Algolia centric, which is hosted on our Algolia doc. You have the view instance search docs. So in this one, you can see all the components. We did a very basic search. There is a lot more components that you can use. All the components, they are customizable, and we did a few customizations, but you can also do a lot more. So I will invite you to go there and check it out. And this app, it's available on GitHub if you want to go and play with it. And that's it for me. Thanks.